Hello, my friend. Welcome to yet another video proudly brought to you by GFM United Prayer and Revival Ministry. I'm Evangelist Gabriel Fernandes, and I'm so happy to be with you today. I'm so happy to be with you today on this special day with some awesome, special sunny weather. You know, I've been waiting for this for a long time, and I've been praying to the Lord. I need some sunny weather. It's really good to actually be here, you know, to be outside and enjoying this awesome weather. Just enjoying the presence of God over here. And once again, I'm in a place where I can just seek God, where I can just come and record this video to you nice and personally without any disturbances. Today, I want to talk to you about something very, very important. And I believe it's the Holy Spirit who put it on my heart last night. You know, even as I was praying, as I was meditating, I believe the Holy Spirit put this on my heart so that I can share this with you so that you can be free. And as you can see, I've got my book of secrets here with me. I call it my book of secrets because it's got most of my revelations that I've got from the Word of God. And I encourage you to get one of these. If you don't have one already, get a journal and write down all the revelations that you get from the Word of God so that you don't have to learn things over and over again. Today, I want to talk to you about being unequally yoked with an unbeliever. The Bible says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 14, it says, "Do not be unequally yoked with an unbeliever." What does this mean, my friends? You know, this is something that's easily been taken out of context. You know, it's something that a lot of people just use. They say, do not be unequally yoked with an unbeliever, but they don't really know what it means. What does this mean? I think in order to understand this, we need to break it down and understand what is a yoke. First of all, before we can understand what it means to be unequally yoked with an unbeliever, we need to understand what is a yoke. So what is a yoke? A yoke is an instrument that used to be used long time ago in the olden days to tie two oxen together to carry a load. So basically, this was an instrument that attached a load to two or more oxen in order for them to carry it forward. So when it talks about a yoke in the Bible, it's always referring to a burden or a load of some sort that you have to carry. And we praise the Lord that Jesus said, "Come to me and find rest, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." In Jesus Christ, your yoke will always be easy and your burden will always be light because He carries the load for you. He knows that on your own you're weak, but with Him you are strong. But taking it back to being unequally yoked with an unbeliever, what does this mean? It means do not find yourself in a situation where you're unequally bound to carry a load with an unbeliever. And this can imply business, it can imply a partnership, it can imply ministry, it can even imply marriage. With that being said, my friend, I want to pray with you and for you so that if you find yourself in any situation where you're unequally yoked, God can set you free. And if you're in a relationship like a marriage that's much more difficult to come out of, then I want to pray for you that God will give you a solution and that God will bring divine grace for you to go forward and for you to enjoy your marriage from this point onwards. Are you ready? Let's get into it. Take your cell phone, take your device, go somewhere private where you can just seek God and touch the hem of His garment. Are you ready? Are you there? Are you in that kind of a place? Let us begin to pray. On this channel, we always begin by lifting up the name of Jesus. So right now, in your own words, just begin to lift up the Lord wherever you are and just receive even as God gives you. You know, when the praises go up, the blessings come down. When the presence of God comes down on our lives, and it comes down when you praise Him, then we are in a place where we can ask God for what we want and things shall be established. So are you ready? Let's go into a time of prayer. Father, You are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the beginning and the end. You are the all-consuming fire. You are worthy of all praise. You are worthy of all honor. You are worthy of all adoration. You are worthy to be lifted up, Lord. Even as I seek You today with my dear friend who's watching this video, Lord. Even as we seek You together, Lord, wherever my dear friend is watching this video. We know that distance is not a barrier. We know that time is never a barrier for You, Lord. And Lord, we know that even as we pray together today, You will answer our prayers with fire because You are the God who speaks and lives. Lord, and You said, whatsoever You ask in my name, it shall be done unto you. Whatsoever you ask in the name of Jesus, it shall be done unto you. So we thank You for that, Lord, and we give You all the glory, honor, and praise, Lord. Lord, I pray, even as I pray with my dear friend today, Lord, if there's any situation where my dear friend might find themselves unequally yoked, meaning in a relationship or in a partnership where the other person is not as committed into that situation as they are, Lord, I pray that You will provide a way out, Lord. Even as we pray, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. My friend, first of all, I want to pray for you. that God will just restore the strength that you've lost being in this relationship or in this yoke where you've been made to carry most of the burden. I'm sure for some of you who've been in this situation, you're feeling very worn out and you're feeling very tired. I want to pray that God will give you back your spiritual energy so that you may go up to the level where you need to be. And then we can continue to pray. Are you ready? Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for my dear friend watching this video. If my dear friend who's watching this video finds himself or herself in a situation where they are tired, they are worn out, they are just finished because they've been carrying most of the load in the relationship or in the situation that they find themselves in, Lord, I pray that you will first of all forgive us for sticking in such a situation for so long, Lord. And Lord, I pray that you may recharge us, give us back the spiritual energy that we need in order to function optimally. Give my dear friend who's watching this video, who feels tired and worn out, the spiritual energy so that my dear friend can be back to normal, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now, Father, I pray for my dear friend who is watching this video, who finds themselves in an unequal relationship or unequal partnership or unequal situation and they want a way out, Lord. Lord, I pray that you will provide a way out, Lord, of that situation, whatever situation it might be. Lord, we know with marriage it's a bit more complicated, Lord. And we know with marriage the only way that someone can come out of that relationship, according to your words, is if there was marital unfaithfulness, Lord. But Lord, I pray, in all situations, you are God. Lord, I pray that you will be God. If it's in marriages, you know what's best, Lord. I pray that your will be done, Lord. If it's in relationships where we can still make a decision, before my dear friend gets permanently yoked into a marriage with a person who doesn't really care so much about what they're doing, Lord, before my friend gets permanently yoked into an equally yoked relationship, Lord, break a way out for my dear friend. Make a way where there seems to be no way, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus.
If you are blessed by these videos and you would like to give a seed, feel free to do so. The link is in the description. All the seeds and the money that comes in goes towards the work of the gospel, and we really appreciate your giving. In saying that, it brings us to the end of the video. God bless you. God keep you. God make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Until we meet again next time, shalom and goodbye.